Today we're here with Cristina, CEO and founder of Pandium, and we're really excited to explore more about what Pandium does. Before we jump into it, Cristina, can you tell us at its core, what is Pandium doing?
Absolutely. So Pandium is an integration platform that makes it easier for every B2B software company to have their own in-app marketplace and also to be present in the marketplaces of their larger partners. So application integration is not what it used to be, and integration is really about distribution and reaching your customers wherever they are, whether that's within your own application or in the marketplace of your larger partners. Pandium is an infrastructure platform that makes it easier for software companies to build and support those marketplaces.
So it sounds like Pandium's helping businesses reach other businesses pretty broadly. Can you tell us a little bit about some of those specific companies and how you've helped them?
Yeah, absolutely. We work across all different verticals, but one of our customers is in the sports management space. Their customers are interested in moving information about their rosters, their invoices, their registrations, into all of the other tools that they use day to day, whether that's an accounting software, a CRM, email marketing, or sports endemic tools that are specific to their industry. We power their integration marketplace so that their customers can go and connect to all of the tools that they use directly from within that application.
Pandium's helping reduce some of the complexity for them and their developers. How are you able to make the developers' lives easier as they're looking to do all these third-party integrations?
Absolutely. So we are a Saas platform, and we help our engineering users build integration scripts in languages that make sense to them without having to deal with a lot of the operational overhead of the marketplace itself, system authentication, logging, enabling their customer support team to help those customers if they have issues. We've productized everything around that exercise so that the engineers at our customers can focus on building out the business logic and not focus on all that infrastructure.
That's awesome. It sounds like you're going to make them happier because they're doing less of the overhead and more of the actual feature design.
That's the goal, yes.
That's great. So can you tell me about some of the Google technologies that enabled you to build Pandium and how you put it all together under the hood?
We are an infrastructure product at our core with some cool features and skins on top of it. And we face a lot of the same problems that any developer platform would face around authentication, security, and storage. We have also the added complexity of running third-party code. So our engineering users at our customer sites actually push code to our platform. So it was really important to us to have an architecture that allowed us to do this safely and securely at scale. It was an obvious choice for us when we learned about Kubernetes to go down the path of microservices. It really allows us to partition our users and our accounts in a safe way so that if code is doing something that we don't need it to, we don't have an issue like a monolithic design where it could take down our entire system. And GCP includes a lot of the kind of universal tools that we need to support Kubernetes at massive scale. We use Google's key management service to manage our authentication into our accounts. And we also use GKE, the managed Kubernetes engine, to take care of a lot of the operational and DevOps overhead so we can focus on building the platform.
So you've got a lot of customers, each with their own Kubernetes clusters and instances. How do you handle the operational load of that growth?
Another great part of using GKE and GCP is that we have a great team of SREs behind us that can help us. It's very, very uncommon that we have an issue with our production account and have to make a ticket with support. But if we do, we know that we're going to get great support, better support than we've gotten when we've used other providers in the past. And we have just a massive team behind us making sure that all of our clusters are running well. That is a resource that is so valuable to us, especially being a growing team. In addition to that, your docs are amazing. We really appreciate that the language in the documentation is not buzzwordy. It makes it a lot easier for us to talk not only internally, but also with our developer users and our product users about our technology when there's common nomenclature that makes sense for everyone and isn't specific to one company.
I'm guessing you have a lot of repeated work each time you're taking on a new client. Are there ways that you've found efficiency so that you can spin up new instances of your services as a new client comes on?
Yes. So Terraform has been great for us. And the fact that Google has templates for Terraform specifically has made our deployment process so much more straightforward. And again, we're not reinventing this wheel. We set this up one time. We want to focus on what we do best and let the folks that do these things great continue to do those things great while we can take advantage of that technology.
Looking back on all the things that you have done, are there any changes you would make or big lessons learned that you want to share?
Yes. So In the very beginning, we rolled our own Kubernetes cluster, did all the management and maintenance ourselves. I think it was a great learning experience because we really got deep into kind of the guts of Kubernetes. But when we learned that GKE was a thing, it was a very obvious choice for us to migrate from another cloud provider to Google. And again, it's been a great experience not having to worry about a lot of the operational and DevOps overhead and just relying on the excellent support that we get from Google. In addition to that, we would probably have gone all in on Stackdriver a little bit earlier. So we were using GCP and GKE, but tried to use other monitoring tools and found them very cumbersome to set up. And they weren't really giving us the deep insights into the kind of nuts and bolts of what was happening in all of our clusters. We decided to give Stackdriver a try, and being a Google product, it was super easy to implement and is very closely tied with GKE. So we were able to really get those insights right out of the box.
That was really cool. Thank you very much for that story. It was great to hear about how you built Pandium, and I appreciate your collaboration and your partnership today.
Thank you for having us.
If you'd like to learn more about Pandium, visit pandium.com. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more episodes of Stack Chat.